When Ukraine's digital minister urged Elon Musk to deploy Starlink systems as Russia occupied the country, he responded promptly. The SpaceX and Tesla founder discussed Russia's invasion of Ukraine, space exploration, and what makes humans unique in an interview with Mathias Döpfner, the CEO of Axel Springer, Insider's parent company. It was intriguing to observe the Russia anti-satellite demonstration a few months ago in the light of this dispute, Musk remarked when asked if there was a potential threat if Starlink satellites were targeted by Russia and China. It caused a great deal of consternation among satellite operators. It even posed a threat to the International Space Station, where Russian cosmonauts are stationed, added he. As previously reported by Insider, the Starlink satellite technology is assisting an elite Ukrainian drone squad in destroying Russian armaments. The method ensures that drone crews may continue to work even if there is no internet or power. However, Musk advised Starlink users in Ukraine to utilize the system only when absolutely necessary, as they could be targeted in the ongoing conflict. It would be difficult to take out the satellites, according to Musk. Trying to knock out Starlink is difficult since there are 2,000 satellites, he explained. He continued, "This entails a large number of anti-satellite missiles. I hope we don't have to put this to the test, but I believe we can deploy satellites faster than anti-satellite missiles can be launched." In the midst of Russia's escalating invasion of Ukraine, SpaceX founder and CEO Elon Musk announced Friday that his company is now working on cyber defense and overcoming signal jamming of its Starlink internet satellites. After the Russian invasion crippled internet connectivity across the country, Musk and SpaceX supplied Starlink terminals to Ukraine at the request of a government official. By Monday, February 28, a shipment of Starlink ground terminals had arrived in Ukraine, which use an antenna and terminal to access the satellite internet service. SpaceX is aiming to keep the terminals online while they are in use, Musk added. Some Starlink terminals in conflict regions were congested for several hours at a time, Musk said Friday on Twitter, March 1. The jamming has been bypassed with our most recent software update. Musk then stated that SpaceX is refocusing its efforts to ensure the continuity of its Starlink service in Ukraine and presumably abroad. SpaceX has refocused on cyber defense and signal jamming, he wrote on Friday. The measures, Musk joked, were unexpected quality assurance work for the Starlink system. Slight delays in Starship and Starlink V2 will be caused by the Starlink work, Musk added. SpaceX's Starship is a massive reusable spacecraft that will launch trips into deep orbit using a massive reusable launcher named Super Heavy. NASA's Artemis program has chosen the Starship vehicle to land men on the moon. In the coming months, SpaceX hopes to launch the first uncrewed Starship orbital voyage. SpaceX's Starlink V2 system is the company's next-generation Starlink system, which includes laser links between satellites and other improvements. Musk warned after shipping Starlink terminals to Ukraine that the system could expose users to Russian military attacks. Important warning, in certain places of Ukraine, Starlink is the only non-Russian communications system still operational, therefore the chances of being attacked are considerable. Please use caution when using this, Musk sent a message on Twitter on Thursday, March 3. Only use Starlink when absolutely necessary, and keep the antenna as far away from humans as feasible, Musk continued. He went on to say, place light camouflage over antenna to evade visual detection. SpaceX sent its latest batch of Starlink satellites into orbit aboard a Falcon 9 rocket on Thursday, March 3. From NASA's Kennedy Space Center's Pad 39A, the mission sent 47 additional Starlink satellites into orbit. SpaceX has launched nearly 2,000 satellites into orbit to date, with aspirations for a 12,000-satellite megaconstellation to give global broadband access.